गुड मॉर्निंग ऑल ऑफ यू. माई सेल्फ संदीप पाराशर एंड आई एम वेलकमिंग यू ऑनलाइन क्लासेस कंप्यूटर क्लास 10th क्लास. 10th क्लास वी आर रीडिंग यूनिट 2nd इलेक्ट्रॉनिक स्प्रेड शीट. इन दिस वी आर रीडिंग चैप्टर नंबर 6 एनालाइजिंग डाटा इन ए स्प्रेड शीट. इन दिस आवर टॉपिक इज गोइंग ऑन वॉट इफ एनालिसिस टूल्स. इन दिस वी हैड कम्प्लीटेड सीनेरियो मैनेजर. सीनेरियो मैनेजर इन दिस वी मेक सम डाटा according to our requirement. We put a value and after that we will check our EMIs and something according to the our changes. Now goal seek. In this, goal seek is another useful data analysis tools of Excel. It is used to set a goal to find the more target variable given with the certain condition. It allow us to try different values in a solution for the input values. In other word, goal seek is another what if analysis tools that helps us obtain the input value, that target value that we want. In scenario manager, we set up everything. We just put value. After that, we can change month and interest rate to calculate EMI. In this, we will give a value. We will set EMIs. We will set months and we want interest rate. Like if anybody want to fill 50,000 per month, then we will check how much interest will come in this ratio. Suppose we want to take a loan of about 6 lakh and repay 25 years, means years and rupees has fixed. Now we can pay an EMI of 50,000. I already told you. So what we do? Enter the data as shown in figure 6.617. In this, they have fixed everything. 25 years and after that loan amount. So enter the formula equal PMT interest rate upon 12 NPR loan amount 0, type in cell B5 and press enter to get the calculated values. Choose data, what if analysis, goal seek. The goal seek dialog box open as shown. In this set cell, in this what is the mean of set cell? $B, $5 means our EMI to value. Value is fixed. Enter the value we want to achieve as a new result, means 50,000 we want. By changing cell, enter the reference for the cell that contain the value you want to adjust in order to reach the target, means interest rate. So it is B1. Click OK. The goal seek status dialog box appear. Now click observe and output as shown, means it will come interest rate 11% will come. Data table, it is similar like Excel. It provide a data sheet to check out every result in a single document. Data table is a way to see different result by altering an input cell in our formula. Instead of creating different scenario, you can create a data table to quickly try out different values for the formulas. We can create one or two variable data tables. In this, we can change our ratio and we can get it our output. No need to make scenario for different bank. We just set up the data and we can collect our output. Now how we do? Select the range of the cell for data table. Here the range of the cells to be selected is B7 I13 B7 to I13, here to here. Click on data, what if analysis, data table. Now data table dialog box open. Row input cell, click on the price cell B3. B3 is the price. Row input cell, click on the price cell B3. Column input cell, quantity cell B4. How much quantity? In the column input cell, click on the quantity cell B4. Now click on OK. Observe the data table that appear as shown figure 6.2.4. This is our data sheet. Now, last not the least, solver. Solver is another what if analysis tool. It follows the goal seek method to solve the equation, but more elaborately. Difference between the only difference between goal seek and solver is that the solver deals with the equation with multiple unknown variables. It is the elaborate form of goal seek. The solver command is not available in Excel. By default, we need to load the solver and using the following steps. How to add? On the file tab, click on option under add in, select solver, add in, click go button. The add-in dialog box open. Click on solver add, check it, and now find solver and analyze the group of data tab. Now what we do? Suppose we are the owner of an automobile service center and planning and providing a new service center for this. We need to buy a new equipment that costs 50,000, which should be paid by installment within 12. So in this, we will calculate EMI's lowest EMI for service that will let me pay for the new equipment. How to do? Cost of new equipment is 50,000. Project clients per month 50. Number of months to pay for equipment B3 upon B4 into B5. Now to find the solution to this problem, choose solver from the analysis group of data tab. After that, the solver parameter window open as shown in 6.2.6. This is our solver parameter. The set objective is the cell containing a formula. The set objective, in this we will set a formula by changing variable cell. In this we will change the variables of cell, like we have 50, so we can change the our data according to our wish. Subject to the constraint. Subject to the constraint is restriction or limit of the possible solution to the problem. To add a constraint, do the following. Click on the add constraint window. Click on the add button to the constraint list. After that, it will add a constraint. What is our constraint? Our constraint is 50. B cell is 50. Click on the solve button and let the solver find out the optimal solution for our problem. When solver has finished processing, it will display the solver result in dialog box. So our month to pay for equipment is 11 and cost per service 83.4. Now my chapter is finished. Thank you. Stay at home. Stay safe.